Welcome to our home, planet Earth. Despite our species' thousands of years on the Earth, there is a lot we still don't know about our planet and how it will change in the future. We know that human populations are growing and changing, that our impact on the planet is increasing at unsustainable rates, and that the planet's climate is getting warmer. As we become more numerous and live longer, our need for food and medication is only going to grow. As demands for food and pharmaceuticals grow, patterns in our use of agricultural and medical chemicals, and the risks these chemicals pose to the environment, will change. But how? We cannot look into the future, but we can do the next best thing: make predictions from what we already know. The European Union wants to be the first climate-neutral continent by the year 2050, and wants a toxic-free environment. To help understand how we can achieve this, adapt to future changes, and live sustainably, they funded ECORISK2050, a network of 13 PhD students supported by universities, public institutions, and industry partners, working across Europe and Israel. Making educated predictions about how chemical use and risks will evolve over the coming decades is not easy, but by breaking the issue down to a series of smaller problems, we can build up our understanding of how these complex and connected factors may change. We are going to look at how these changes in patterns will affect how chemicals are used and emitted, how they move and mix in lakes, rivers, and streams, and what effects they will have on the creatures that call these waters home. Once we understand how the exposure to and the effect of chemicals may change in the future, we can assess the risks these chemicals will pose to the environment under global change scenarios. Once we understand the risks, we can start developing strategies to help minimize and mitigate the effects of chemicals on humans and the environment, so that we can live within the planet's limits. Over the next 3 years, we will be studying, experimenting, and building predictive models to understand all these concerns. Keep an eye on our website at ecorisk2050.eu and on Twitter at ecoitn to stay up to date on our latest findings.